joined by CCNC, and we're going to be taking a look at game number three. Look at us, we rhymed. Game number three here of Team Secret facing off against Ad Finem, and it's an Oracle first pick. CCNC, how are you doing? You said that you feel like these teams are pretty evenly matched. What to you, is there a hero that you feel like might stand out as the hero that's going to win you the game here in game number three?
I don't know. I don't know if there's one specific hero, to be honest, but it seems like in the at least these past two games, the team that hasn't had to make all the moves and be the one pressuring is the one that won, so we'll see if that happens again or break the trend.
Yeah, definitely. Well, it's going to be a Coddle PA start for Team Secret. PA, there's a couple of different ways that we've seen her run. Most recently, one of the standout ways was as a support PA, but did get the change to her dagger. Do you think that that's still a viable option?
Yeah, I do. I think it's more of a viable option in off lanes now, helping out an off laner or like zoning a safe laner, less so zoning the mid, because you end up sapping a lot of his XP and it's sort of crummy. But I think I've seen Secret do this before, and I think they typically play the PA as a mid and then you know, obviously run the Coddle as a support whenever they do this Coddle PA strat. They just double dagger.
Do you think that that's pretty strong, or is it like kind of gimmicky? What's the best way that it gets played in?
I mean, I think it's all right. I don't know if it's first two worthy. Finem got the Sand King, which is one of PA's hardest counters, so already not like an amazing game for the PA, so we'll see how it turns out. But I think the one game or two games I saw them do this strategy, I think they lost, so we'll see.
Yeah, definitely. It could be an interesting way to look at it. If they do run like the Coddle PA constantly throwing out daggers, would you like to have another hero in that lane that's farming, or do you kind of like the PA against? I guess it's all going to come down to what heroes they take a little bit later. We can take a look at what these drafts might end up saying about that, as it's already going to be the Jug, the Timbersaw, the Sven, and the Lifestealer band. Anything hopping out to you that's kind of interesting about these so far?
Not really so much, to be honest. Just like banning heroes either they don't like dealing with, or heroes that are, you know, Sven's obviously good versus PA because the you can cleave her. If you ever hit her, like, because the evasion is nice or whatever, but eventually the Sven is going to hit you. Whenever he does hit you, you're going to evaporate. He can cleave you. 10 seconds remaining. Just some general bans. I think Madara really likes the Juggernaut, so maybe a little bit of a respect ban. Timber for Ev plays a really, really mean Timber. So yeah, I think just some slight respect bans, maybe just stuff they don't want to play versus, nothing too fancy, I don't think.
Yeah, makes sense. Very, very interesting. And yeah, it's something also with the Darkseer getting taken from Ad Finem. You think about if a Sand King stun comes in after a Vacuum Wall and then a couple of Sven swipes, it could be an issue as well. I feel like Team Secret kind of had an idea that Darkseer might have been the pickup and ban out a couple of those stronger melee cores. But do you think that it might be worth it for Ad Finem to go back for a Slark now? You said that it was one of Madara's best heroes. Do you like it in this instance?
Yeah, it's pretty good. I think they probably will actually pick it up. I'm curious what Secret is going to pick for their safe lane, because if this is a Sand King Darkseer dual off lane, they're going to have issues, because that dual lane is ridiculous. So I don't know what they're going to pick here, to be honest. Then maybe they'll run Sand King in a tri lane, but if Secret picks a weak laner, then Ad Finem can definitely punish, so.
Well, they're going to take the Tidehunter, at least for now. One of the ways that we've been seeing Coddle get played, particularly in the Chinese scene, is as part of an aggro tri lane where he just spams out Illuminate. You would also have, in this instance, spamming out the dagger with the Chakra Magic. We've already talked about that. And then Bounty Hunter roaming in from time to time to just try and mess with them. What do you think would that be a good thing to run and then have Tidehunter against either a Darkseer or a Sand King or both of them? Is that lane okay for him?
It's all right, initially. Eventually it gets to the point where the Sand King just starts exploding a lot of creeps, and then you have issues. But I mean, it'll be Darkseer off lane, so that lane is definitely Darkseer favored. But I mean, the title farm, It sort of depends on what their last hero is. Akado P, I think the PA will be mid. I don't think it'll be in the safe lane. Safe lane PA is kind of weak because it's hard for you to get around and start doing stuff. You know, because you are a safe laner, it's sort of awkward. You know, you're far away from two of the lanes. And also she really needs the level so you can get the higher range on the dagger early on. So I think it'll be a mid PA. And they'll be looking for a safe laner in their last pick. So I think that'll sort of decide if they're going to do an aggro try or sort of like one of those dual lanes where the bounty hunter does his own thing.
Well, and there it is. They are going to take the Slark now. Yeah, and I guess that's something else to keep in mind is bounty hunter roaming around in the mid lane also with the PA there. They can probably find some amount of damage onto whoever Ad Finem decide to stick into that lane. But for now, Bands, is there anybody that you particularly like with Ad Finem that they could take? We talked about Puck earlier. Is that a decent pick here?
Puck's all right. They want something more... I'm not sure. Puck is alright. They may actually pick it. I just don't think Puck is that good of a hero, but they really like it, so they may take it. They may also put the Sand King mid versus the PA because that lane is abysmal for PA.
Ooh.
And I know Thug, you know, once again plays obscure heroes, so they may put the Sand King mid and then pick another support. I find that less likely. They probably will just take the Puck. Because they dark, you know, Darkseer is a pretty farm intensive hero. Slark is a pretty farm intensive hero.
Yeah.
We'll see.
I mean, Invoker's still in the pool too. Storm Spirit available. Those might be other heroes that Secret could be looking to that Ad Finem might want to ban out. Yeah. Is there any mid hero that particularly destroys Puck or destroys Slark? Sorry.
Storm. Storm is okay. Pretty good for Secret here. Storm is the hardest counter in the game versus Slark. Because the Storm, when he has an Orchid, can always kill the Slark, and the Slark can absolutely never kill the Storm unless Slark is ridiculously far ahead.
Okay. Well, we'll see if Ad Finem do indeed want to pick that now. With 42 seconds left in the game, it's certainly a possibility as far as banning out that hero. Could they take it for themselves? It doesn't look like there's a lot of counter or like a lot of control for a Storm on Secret's lineup.
Maybe it's probably too farm intensive because they do have a Slark and a Darkseer, so there won't really be heroes to move around the map that much. Storm isn't great at like making moves on either of those cores, like a PA or a Tide. He can't really kill them early on. So I don't think Ad Finem will take it themselves. I also don't think Thug plays Storm. He plays more space creative heroes typically. And less farm intensive heroes, so I think they maybe could take it. It's not great, but I don't think they will.
It feels to me like Team Secret just want to run at Ad Finem. You got Keeper of the Light who can keep people topped off. You've got PA, obviously, great at it. Bounty Hunter and Tide Hunter. Like, these guys, they're all about it. I mean, they've got two Hunters and an Assassin. This is a dangerous lineup here.
Yeah, they're... Oh, Ember Spirit. Oh gosh, this is the best Animage game of all time. Holy cow.
All right. So you're taking Team Secret to win this one.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, Animage is so good versus Ember and Slark, and Darkseer and Oracle. This is a ridiculous Animage game.
Oh, it hurts. It hurts. We'll see if Ad Finem can pull it back regardless of that and Secret are going to actually be able to execute properly. You felt like it came down to the draft both games. Was there anything out of either side that might sway you one way or the other as far as their actual play? Like one team that you feel like has been playing better than the other?
I feel like Secret's been playing a little bit cleaner, executed their strategies a little bit better. Their last game was just hard for them to win at the draft. But the game where they did have the better draft, they like just absolutely dominated. Whereas the game, you know, the second game where Ad Finem had a slightly in the draft, it was a lot closer, a little shaky, some mistakes that almost give Secret the game. So yeah, I think Secret has been playing a little better, and I also think they have the
Kato. He's got a unicorn as a little horse. Look at him; he's just happy. That's a nice little guy.
Yeah, the one horn.
Wait, I love this. Is that now?
Why is it called a rare poke?
I don't know.
Like it's the one horn under that in blue, rare poke, exclamation mark. What does that even mean?
I'm not really sure. The rare poke. So maybe he rarely pokes somebody? Could be the option.
It's like I'll put that there. It's not even like he renamed. I'm so confused.
I do really love the Bounty Hunter Stevie Ray Vaughan hat. It's wonderful. As a Stevie Ray Vaughan fan myself.
Very stylish.
Absolutely. Well, early wards dropped out. Puppy playing the Bounty Hunter from game number one, where he did a pretty great job. Or actually, that was game number two, excuse me. Game number one was the Pudge. How did you feel like his Bounty Hunter played in that first one?
I think it was he played pretty well. I mean, as far as like, you know, big plays or stuff of that kind, not really so much, because, you know, he is just a Bounty Hunter. But in the mid game where they started to come back, he was, you know, in the right place at the right time a lot of times, scouting people out, especially those couple of times where they kill people by the Dire Hard Cannon, the tier 2 mid, spotting people out, getting the Animage, the pot him a couple of times. So yeah, I think Puppy definitely knows his way around a Bounty Hunter.
All right. Well, we'll see if they're able to find himself the levels and stuff that he needs. But it does look like it's going to be mid one playing that PA in the mid lane. And meanwhile, MP will be on the anti-mage. So very scary game right now for Advenom.
Yeah, the Slark versus anti-mage carry matchup is incredibly abysmal for the Slark.
So break it down for me. What happens in it?
For the early lane, you know, obviously they'll both farm. What happens is, like, once Slark gets to Lothar's, the Animage will typically be getting close to Battle Fury, and so Slark wants to fight around that period and, like, get pickoffs, but he can't pick off the Animage. So the Animage just sort of walks around and farms and outfarms the Slark, and it gets to the point where once Animage has Manta, you can never really kill the Anti-Mage, and the Anti-Mage, if the Slark ever gets stunned, burns all his mana, he can't ult, and then the Slark just dies.
Oh man, this is scary indeed. Thug, brought down to 30 HP, is going to use the salve, and in the meantime, Puppy is hanging out by this tower, waiting for the courier to come back. I don't know if he'll spot out where exactly it goes, but definitely a chance at a snipe if they are a little bit too careful with that courier, man. Puppy wants that courier so bad. Does he spot it? He might even just head in.
He knows where. Yeah, it's dead.
Oh, there it is. Courier goes down. Nicely played by Puppy. And you said that this was pretty much always a mistake at this point in time, like after having all those Bounty Hunter patches. Can you fault Advenom for that?
I mean, yeah, like whenever there's a Bounty Hunter in the game, you just sit the thing on your hill, or a support brings you the salve until you see the Bounty Hunter. Because, like, especially considering what Puppy did last game, you know, going for the quarter, he seems to prioritize that, so. Yeah.
Well, mid lane, they found and found first blood. They burrow struck forward and turn on Flame Guard. Suddenly, Coddle not so tanky. They end up taking that kill.
Yeah, he didn't see that coming at all. Like, he was just standing there, like, illuminating. Yeah, they can't kill me, and then they killed him.
That's frustrating. Puppy, in the meantime, picks up a regen, and looks like they want to head down towards the bottom lane and apply a bit more pressure there. You've brought Pylai Dai in the area, Illuminate available, and they actually find Puppy. Dust used, and Burrow Strike again. They have the Fortune's End. He might be in trouble. Can they find Second Blood? They connect as well onto the Pounce, and Oracle gets the kill. In the meantime, those Spartans going to drop as well. So a little bit of a awkward play there. I don't know if they can find Madara off of this. Yeah, with the Oracle in the air, they'll keep him safe.
Yeah, this bottom lane is going to start getting pretty rough for the Slark pretty soon. He's gonna have to use his salve here, or at least a lot of his tango is gonna keep getting illuminated. So they definitely understand how weak Slark is early in lane and are massively pressuring him. He has about the same amount of last hits as Animage, but that's quickly gonna change as the Animage will get his Ring of Health. And
yeah, even taking a point in Gush right now on the Tidehunter, they just realize, like you said, that they can bully this guy and causing a lot of trouble. There's the Anchor Smash, Puppy in the area as well. Still only level 1 with very little experience going his way. And this has left a mid-matchup where Ember Spirit is just going to have to man up against the Phantom Assassin, but it's feeling really good right now for Secret. And this is a rough lane. Oh, Madara found. Right-clicked, gushed. He is going to pounce out of there, dropped very low, and can they find the kill? It looks like they will get it. Pylai Dai takes him down.
Yeah, this is the nightmare scenario for Slark. He has one Tango left and is only level 3. So it's going to be a while before he gets his level 6, and they're just going to keep diving his tower and just continue to just crush him. The Tide also has Arcanes now, so it's even more Illuminate spam and Anchor Smash spam. So the Slark is not in a happy place.
Oh man, Thug is playing dangerous as well in the mid lane here. Has the 6 wand charges, but just playing around the cooldowns of that PA and trying to get whatever he can. He's holding on to that wand. That's actually really good, the fact that he didn't have to pop it there. You can feel very safe in that lane.
Yeah, this lane is very hard for Ember because it's...
Oh my god, maybe next time. And again, gonna drop. They have Madara here as well. They're gonna bring in Spartan. Has a Burrow Strike. Only level 1 on the Caustic as well. And Shuriken gets thrown out also, chasing down Madara. Might be able to find him. They do bring down Puppy, but they're gonna lose the Slark again. And Spartan now turned upon. Pile Dai is there. They're gonna have to bring the Oracle back in towards them, but looks like they might get him. Coddle, double kill for Pylai Dai, making it happen, and wanted to try to catch on Ferev with the Fortune's End, but wasn't quite there in time. So, man, Secret getting away with murder in this bottom lane.
Pylai Dai, the legend.
He's doing a great job. He's going to have his Tranquils now as well. Over here towards the top lane, MP has got complete and total free farm. I mean, Slark's only like 10 CS behind. Is this still just as bad as it looks for Ed Venom?
Yeah, because the Slark had to buy a new set of Tangos, he had to buy a TP, he lost gold whenever he died, and so even though he's like only 10 CS, 11 CS down or whatever, it's actually quite a bit more than that gold-wise. He's down...
500.
Yeah, so like 600-700 or whatever, so it's not just like 10 CS worth. And the biggest thing about it is Slark needs to be ahead in that matchup to be okay for him. So whenever you're behind, it's not a good sign.
Yeah. Well, Ad Finem in the meantime are gonna try and take something back, but the Burrow Strike doesn't connect. The Fortune's End coming a bit too late, and this is a lot of experience into Ferev's pockets. Man, he is gonna have level 6 pretty soon, and that's where things really start to get rough. I mean, Slark right now, he's almost level 5, but I don't know. It's a hard game.
It's very, very difficult to get to your level 6 in situations like this, where they start to take over the lane, get lane control, pressure your tower and stuff. You have the support sitting there that's trying to help you, and so he's taking a little bit of the XP. It's just kind of a disaster, these scenarios for the Slark.
I found mid one. Gonna turn onto him, and Thug dropping somewhat low. They do have Blink Strike away, and actually go to Puppy, and turns now onto Spartan, but not gonna be able to get into range of that Ember, unfortunately. But nonetheless, a very frightening prospect in the mid lane when your PA is willing to dive you, because they can't even really TP in towards mid, because if they do, that leaves Madara exposed, and just seen over and over again how willing Secret is to dive this.
Yeah, they're putting pressure on all the lanes at the same time. Mid one's playing super aggressive because he knows, like you said, that they can't really rotate because they have to stay down here in Hadara. Pressuring as much as they can.
Skylark able to get away from that one, but meanwhile, bottom lane, Ferev, did they overextend? They have Ravage available. They are going to jump now immediately on a Pylai Dai. Just going to TP out right in front of, doesn't manage to escape, unfortunately, and Ember Spirit is going to find that kill. Nicely played by Thug. So they do finally take down Pi on that Coddle.
Yeah, it was a nice rotation. I really had to start and go and get something done because mid one is just free farming. The Ember's free farming as well, but in a game like this, you can't just sit and farm. And if you are getting a lot of farm, you have to help your team out, especially in a matchup like this game where the cores of Secret stack up very well against the cores of Ad Finem.
Well, mid one in the meantime has been able to pick up a DD rune for himself, and there's a decent chance that they could fight around this a little bit as well and start to dole out some serious deeps to the Ember Spirit. In the meantime, MP is just pushing away. I mean, 53 last hits at 8 minutes and top of the CS, everything else, Mark. He is feeling really good.
Yeah, already got his treads up, Ring of Health, casual Ring of Regen, working towards the Battle Fury, playing on a good...
Oh, God.
Wow.
DD Rune looking for more. Oh, Madara, you got to run, mister. This is a real problem. Ravage getting ready to drop. They do have Dark Pact available, which might keep them a little bit more alive. But, yeah, this is... That's ulti. That's everything. Ravage drops. Able to Dark Pact it off, but I don't think it's going to save him. Just too Double much dagger. Damage. DD mid one. And now the tower probably going to fall off the back of this.
Yeah, they're going to get the tower, have control of the Slark's jungle, and so now the problem only escalates because not only is the Slark behind, but he's also not going to be able to have the space to catch up. They're going to take control of his jungle, ward up his camps, you know, get vision of him so he can't walk from camp to camp as fast, and just continue to just make this Slark's life absolutely miserable.
Top lane is still being pressured somewhat, which is decent, but yeah, this just means that they're going to bring MP down here to the bottom lane, and he's going to push it out again himself, so... A very hard game indeed, and it looks like they actually are going to TP in and try and mess with the Sand King. They do scan out the area to make sure that nobody else is there, and now going to Blinding Light Skylark back in some trouble. Mid one finds him with the dagger. There's the jump forward. Burrow Strike, is it going to be enough to create that separation? Doesn't look like it. Gush comes in to find the kill, and now TP in towards mid lane looking for Thug. Puppy is there. Oh, dagger, crit, is it crit, enough? Crit. It's not there. Oh my god. Oh, that was scary.
You have to root for the RNG.
Yeah, you gotta root for the RNG. Well, at Finnum, feeling very scared, but you said this is Madara's best hero. Can you play yourself out of this with the Slark?
They have to. He needs to like wait till he gets some core items. Maybe treads. Maybe Aquila. And I don't think he can actually wait for the Shadowblade. I think he fights before then. And he just goes for more of an aggressive playstyle with like treads, Aquila, something like that. And they go and take fights early on because if he tries to farm this Lothar's, he's never gonna get there.
Yeah. I did like him holding on to that ulti as long as possible, realizing that if you pop it then you basically can't go back into farm anymore. So, well, jump in onto Thug. They turn. Don't quite catch the chains, unfortunately. Too slow down to really throw out a Remnant and chase either. And man, mid one is just abusing the entire Ad Finnum team with the dagger spam. All right, Thug jumps forward. Another Blinding Light back. Ally die, keeping them at bay. And they keep on taking this daggers to the face.
Yeah, this dagger spam is absolutely brutal for a hero with low armor, like Ember Spirit, only 5 armor. So with the Blightstone, it takes them all the way down to 3. And with the massive physical damage because of the phase boots, just getting double daggered all the time, it's super annoying.
Oh, great stuff from Secret. And I'll add Finnum, they kind of got their backs up against a wall here. I mean, you still have Oracle, almost level 6 at this point. Like, the saves are going to be there to some extent, but it feels like Secret are winning by virtue of just being more efficient around the map as opposed to getting killed off continuously.
Yeah, and also this bringing the Animage down here to this bottom line, super good play, because the Animage can solo the Slark and then take his jungle. So the Slark can't even push out his in and farm these jungle camps because the Animage can solo him, and the Animage also gets free farm. And it lets the support take top lane and just sort of spreads out the farm better and while also shut down the Slark. So a really nice rotation by the Coddle bringing him down there.
Well, a very rough one indeed. And this has led us to the tune of 6,000 gold lead and right around 4,000 experience. I really feel like Ad Finnum at this point. Like, there's ways back into it by virtue of getting levels. They just need to hold out for a little while longer. What's going to be the point where they're going to be capable of fighting? Is it around, like, more points in vacuum? Is it the Blink Dagger up on these heroes? I mean, does Darkseer have to finish off his mechanism first?
I mean, team fight-wise, like 5v5, I don't think they can ever fight them. Okay. They have to look for small skirmishes, I think, with Sand King, smoking with Slark, maybe Oracle as well. While Ember Spirit tries to farm up, Darkseer gets lanes out, and then maybe puts an Iron Shell on the Slark. And look for small skirmishes, trying to find Animage after he blinked to a camp. PA playing too aggressive, because mid one has been playing it very aggressive, they may try and punish that. Something like that are sort of the plays they need to make, because they can't really 5v5 fight them. Ravage is just too strong of a spell, Blinding Light, Tracks, stuff like that. They just really don't have the damage to do anything about it.
Still waiting for the rest of Secret to get back into this one. It looks like they're mid one having a little bit of issues, either with internet or something going on, but certainly not having an issue when she's actually in the game. Almost going to be able to complete off a Desolator. This should probably come at around, what, like 13 minutes or so?
Yeah, for too long. 13, 14 minutes around there. Very fast, for sure.
It's...
back. Oh.
Joking. Ha ha ha. Ja lol.
XD.
You love it.
A classic. Right.
Come on, guys. Get your shiz together. Let's do it. I believe in you. Man, look at the three cores. Look at the three cores. What is that? It's like, nope, just kidding.
I like how he doesn't say, like, sorry or whoops or my bad or something, just joking.
Yep. I wonder, well, they didn't actually say go. You see, it was all ad finem, it looks like.
No, oh, wait, no, Ferev.
Okay, he did. You're right. God dang it, Ferev. We need to talk again.
He was joking. It's fine.
Oh, God. Double dagger spam. Almost killing off Thug. Oh, man, it hurts. And like you were saying, bottom lane, MP is just able to bully around this Slark.
Yeah, just getting absolutely pummeled. You could see Seeker probably saw the Slark coming and was hoping they'd let the Animage through, and they banned the Morphling. I guess they forgot about the Animage, and now they're regretting their forgetfulness.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the second game in a row where it's felt like Anti-Mage has just kind of taken over. And Oracle is going to be able to sit here, try and soak up whatever experience possible. You desperately need to get that level 6, though, and it's like Bounty is... actually already there. So track online.
Oh, it looks like Madaria is taking a similar route. He's going to the Lothar's first and not going for a Treads or an Aquila or anything like that. So the same sort of thought process and the same sort of things you can do with the Lothar's before the Treads. Just trying to fight as early as possible and hit that timing. Maybe get some skirmishes and fight their way back into the game.
Well, they spot out Madara there. Might actually be able to go for him, possibly. Thinking about it. Madara, say it ain't so, tracked up and brought down. Oh, mid one killing spree. It hurts. That really hurts.
That is super unfortunate. He's actually getting pretty close to his Lothar's as well, setting him back quite a bit. Gonna slow down Athenum's ability to take those fights and sort of, once again, slowing down their only real way back into this game, which is small skirmishes. Seeker knowing exactly what to do with their drafts.
Oh, Spartan's thinking about it. They got Epicenter. They're going, get over here, Ferev. We want a party. And they got the Iron Shell on top of them as well. Triple Remnant forward. All right, we're getting this damn kill.
That's the kind of stuff they have to do, just dumping ults on people, getting whatever they can.
That's good stuff. I like that. Well, in the meantime, they might pay for it. Puppy gonna throw out the track. Skylark just trying to escape, and yeah, it looks like everybody's gonna TP out of there.
P only away from the Battle Fury.
Yeah.
Wild can I give it to him. Bam. Got it. 14 minutes, super good timing, especially considering how much he's moved around the map and pressured the Slark. Over 2k ahead already.
Now he comes in and steals the last bit of his creeps as well. Oh my god, Madara. This really hurts. You gotta feel for the guy. It's been a tough one.
Yeah, playing Slark versus Animage is never fun. Literally never fun.
Jeez. And PA has her Desolator now. The tower is gonna start to fall. And, I mean, you can see that Ad Finem, they're, like, making the best of it that they can. They found that kill onto Ferev. They're sort of able to push out these waves pretty continuously. And, oh, Jukes away from the Tidehunter there to do a little double take as to where that Sand King went. But it does feel like they're at least sort of salvaging, I don't know, what could be five lost team fights in a row if Ad Finem were sort of standing up against these guys.
Yeah.
God.
That double dagger with the Deso now. If he crit one of those, Thug would be dead.
Yeah. Oh God, he's that is gonna be an escape. Thug just hitting the panic button trying to get out of there. Oh,
yeah,
mid one.
Very close.
That was actually, I think, a really good play. Did he remnant through the dagger so he didn't take the damage from it? Could have. That would have been a kill otherwise, I think. Oh, maybe next time is going to drop here. Able to get his ultimate off. Needs to get out of here as quickly as possible. And pops his one charge as well. He should actually live through this. Maybe not the second dagger. The Ravage pops. Catch on to 3, 4. Oh, Frev's doing a lot of damage in the midst of this. Epicenter comes out onto Frev again. But he is so tanky. And now mid one, dropping low. They do find the kill. Whoa. All right, another one going back the other way. They're controlling MP for the moment. Puppy dropped low. Is going to die to that. Thug is looking to escape. And out of mana, bottle charge, needs to juke the other way, is running out of here, and now they get the double blink from MP, nicely played in that way, but I think that Thug is probably going to... No, they actually let him out. Great fight for AdFinim, all things considered.
Yeah, mid one going way too ham there, underestimating the amount of damage from the double ion shell, blinking and just sort of evaporating there.
So that's something I wanted to ask you about. Some of the PAs that we've watched recently have gone for like a Vanguard first and then afterwards taking the Desolator just to get that extra bit of survivability. Do you think this is a mistake by PA going for just the poor man's shield, so not really increasing her HP that much?
I don't really think so. Vanguard doesn't really help her survivability that much. If anything, she could go something like a pipe, or not a pipe, like a casual hood that would probably give her more survivability than a Vanguard, because most of their damage, if you know, at this stage, basically all of it is magical. So if she was scared of dying, pipe or a hood probably be better. But as the game is going, there's not really a way that they can get on top of the PA, so it's really just up to her making a mistake. That wasn't so much up to like the item build or anything like that. I think it was just a little bit of over-aggressiveness.
So a Vanguard would not have saved her there, is what you're telling me, that it was just by virtue of a little bit of a misplay.
It maybe would have just from the raw HP, but I mean, she probably wouldn't have got like those kills either if she had a Vanguard instead of a Deso, so...
Oh, Shadowblade, they're looking. They have Epicenter, Blink Dagger... available if Spartan can find it. Blinks forward, able to find the PA. Now in a little bit of trouble though, he doesn't have Sandstorm. Remnant forward onto several. Ravage not up again for 20 seconds, and Madara is trying to do as much as he can in the midst of this team fight, but that's already two down. MP finds a double and everybody else needs to escape. They don't get the Slark, but they do find that Darkseer and the Sand King in the meantime. Thug getting chased down as well. They throw out the chains. Is he going to be able to get out of here? Trying to remnant away. They do still have that vision tracked down. All right, sleight of fist, but it was never going to be enough. As soon as he got caught by that dagger, he was dead.
Fortunately, he didn't have a remnant out, so he couldn't get out the easy escape. Oh, I'm going to get the Roshan now, too.
Well, you talked about the strength of this secret lineup and how AdFinim are pretty heavily outdrafted. Are they starting to make some of the moves, at least, that allow them to get back into this game?
A little bit. Going for that big scale fight mid, I don't think really was the right thing. What happened behind the bottom tower, sort of like kiting them around, you know, sacking the heroes you need to. And using your burst damage like over and over again, kiting around, getting your spells off to turn that fight around.
High light die. Oh god, blinding light. Oh no, and now the man of well, oh my god, he's just gone. Oh, mid one doing a lot of damage. Wow, that hurt.
Yeah, the daggers are fierce. Just going into a BKB as well. Only the recipe away right now, so
man.
Really getting up there. Animage with a Manta already at 19 minutes.
Oh, and now they found... Alright, now he's going to be able to Shadowblade away. I thought Madara was going to get caught. Actually, they Blinding Light him back into it. And now they have the mana leak. They have vision of him. Madara pushed back in again. Pylite died, making the plays for his teams. He has to pop the ulti. They're going to relocate back in. MP, everybody there. Dropped down low in a mega kill streak for MP. Just dismantling this Slark, and oh, it is a hard life indeed.
Yeah, being 6k gold down on an anti-mage as a Slark is not good times.
Oh, that hurts. And it's, we talked about in the draft if it was going to be the, oh, you know what? If he's not careful, all right. I thought that they were going to be able to like find the kill onto him with like a mana void or something, or mana leak. Mid one spots him. Unable to get the kill though. But we talked in the draft that in game number one, Secret banned out the Slark. In game number two, they let it through, and then they take the last pick anti-mage. Do you think that this was something that was set up and Secret were ready for the Madara Slark?
I think so, but it's sort of weird because Aghanim should have banned the Animage whenever they took the Slark. That's just sort of a like just a thing you do because Animage is so good versus Slark. So it's almost like they maybe had another answer for it, and they were like, oh, okay, we're gonna get the Animage instead. All right, we'll take that. And that's what it sort of felt like. I'm not sure why Aghanim didn't ban the Animage.
Yeah. This is a little bit weird. I guess they just felt like they could play around it, but regardless, it has been a tough go for them. They do have Ferev that's in the area, and they might try and go for a play against him here. Again, Epicenter is available, but they're not going to get it.
Yeah, Aghanim are in a very scared position right now, having a lot of map cut off. P just cutting off massive portions of it, out farming them.
Thug is gonna remnant back away. The problem is the rest of Secret was waiting and realizing what was coming, they take down that Ember Spirit.
Pi's been playing really well this game, being in the right place at the right time, non-stop, getting a really good blast. Somebody's relocating his cores in at the right times to speed up their farm, to go to fights and stuff. Hasn't really died much in a game where they have very good heroes at killing a Caudle, if they get on top of them.
Yeah. Well, and it's just to me again the blinding light, how much knockback you get from that. Great against the Sand King, vacuum all into two, and is going to throw out another one. There's the blinding light. Get away from my puppy. And now maybe gonna drop. They find the kill onto Darkseer, looking for maybe next time. He's out of mana and is going to try and escape, but there is not much hope of him surviving, even in Fountain. He
My
does
fairy
eventually
fires.
pop. Oh man. Did he buy Fairy Fires?
No, it would've been
Oh.
cool if he did though.
God, and yeah, they actually spot out Spartan. He is, it looks like he's typing to his team, but it's actually just gonna get out of there.
Tabbed out.
Oh, God.
PA has the BKB now, so almost impervious versus their spells, because that's almost all of Aghanim's damage is spells.
God. And it keeps on. I mean, even in that one instance where they jump on a puppy, they do manage to find the kill. Blinding Light is just feeling so impactful.
Yeah, it is a very good spell. And you can feel the frustration of like playing as a Slark versus an Animage, like in those early lane, like in the early lane, he's just getting dumped on and he knows what's coming.
Yeah.
Yeah, anyway, he's gonna port down there and he's gonna sit in his lane.
And I mean, they're ready. They're taking down the tier two tower here. The Aegis is gonna expire, so there might be a bit of an opening, but I find it hard to imagine them taking down mid one through a BKB. Remnant is right up in front of everybody else. They could go for a big play here again. Vacuum Wall available, catches onto two. The Burrow Strike as well
Nice
immediately
ravage.
reacts. Ferev jumping onto all of them, killing spree for the AM. They're just gonna dismantle that Oracle as well. And now Tier 3 is gonna get turned upon. No great way to stop it. Darkseer buys back into the game. They need to throw out a second layer of nukes though, because right now, oh my god, Secret is just getting whatever they want.
Yeah, they pick better heroes and they played their drafts well, and now there's not much that Venom can do, to be honest.
Oh, turned onto Madara. He's out of mana. Gets another stick charge pop, so gonna be fine for the moment. They do have the Coddle, though, with the Ags to heal everybody back up, and meanwhile, the dagger spam keeps on coming out. Vacuum Wall into several, but it doesn't look like it's gonna be enough. That's a dead Darkseer. Sand King gone as well, and a very disheartening GG from the Greek team Ad Finem as Secret end up taking it 2-1. Well, it sucks too, because those first couple of games were really strong.